Plummer-Vinson syndrome or Paterson-Brown-Kelly syndrome is a rare condition characterized by the classical triad of post-cricoid dysphagia, iron-deficiency anemia and upper esophageal web. This syndrome was named after two Mayo Clinic physicians, Henry Stanley Plummer and Porter Paisley Vinson. In the United Kingdom, it is known as Paterson-Brown-Kelly syndrome after two British laryngologists, Donald Rose Paterson and Adam Brown-Kelly. Etiology of PVS remain unknown, so the proposed etiopathogenic mechanisms include nutritional and iron deficiency anemia, vitamin B deficiency, genetic predisposition, autoimmunity and immune dysregulation. Most patients with PVS are initially asymptomatic, classically present as a triad of iron deficiency anemia, post-cricoid dysphagia and upper esophageal web. Dysphagia is painless and slowly evolving, starting with solid foods, and dysphagia becomes symptomatic only when the luminal diameter in the region of esophageal web becomes less than 12 millimeters. Iron deficiency anemia can present as dyspnea, tachycardia, fatigue, glossitis, angular keelitis and choelonychia, or the classical spoon-shaped nails. There should be very high level of clinical suspicion in patients with iron deficiency anemia, esophageal web and dysphagia. Hematological testing is done to confirm the cause of iron deficiency anemia. It includes a complete blood count, peripheral smear and iron studies including serum iron, ferritin, total iron binding capacity, etc. And radiological investigations such as barium swallow, video fluoroscopy and dynamic X-ray is essential. Esophagoscopy is the safest and most reliable investigation to find out a case of PVS. During esophagoscopy, esophageal web will appear as smooth, thin and grey lesions with normal appearing mucosa and a central or lateral lumen. Dysphagia in many patients resolve with iron supplementation only. Elemental iron in the range of 150 to 200 mg is generally required. More advanced diseases not responding to iron supplementation may need endoscopic dilatation. So, commonly used techniques are endoscopic balloon dilatation or a Savary-Gilliard dilator. Needle knife electroincision has been proposed as a therapeutic alternative to dilatation. There is an increased risk, around 3 to 15% of increased risk of developing squamous cell carcinoma of the hypopharynx or upper esophagus, which is related to chronic iron deficiency. So, Plummer-Vinson syndrome is a rare disease. It's a classical triad of iron deficiency anemia, dysphagia, and upper esophageal web.